Marketers typically work with hundreds of leads at once, but usually just a fraction of these leads deserves the personal attention of a salesperson. Use automated lead scoring to help bring your most promising leads to the top as soon as they qualify. With Dynamics 365 for Marketing, you can view a lead score according to each scoring model, right from a lead form. The system is easy to customize with workflows and business processes that will automatically identify the best, sales-ready leads as defined by your own organization's criteria for success. To set up your lead scoring system, go to Lead Scoring Models, where you can work with existing models and create new ones. Like most content designers in Dynamics 365, the Scoring Designer features a toolbox with tiles that you can drag to the canvas to assemble your model. Build your model by establishing a set of condition and action pairs. Each condition holds a collection of rules, and each action controls how the score is affected when its condition is true. The condition tile establishes a name for the condition and always contains at least one child tile, which establishes logic for the condition. You can design complex conditions by dragging additional condition tiles onto the parent from the toolbox. All the conditions nested here must resolve to true for the attached action to be taken. Select a child condition tile to set up the logic for that tile. The condition can test for values found on the lead record itself, such as the city where the lead lives, or for values of records related to the lead, such as email clicks made by the lead. Use the entity field to choose the type of entity you want to test. For example, choose email clicked to increase the score when a contact clicks a link in a marketing email message you sent them. Set the frequency to each to increase the score for each click, or set to at least 3 to increase the score by a fixed amount for 3 or more clicks. You can also establish a date range so that older clicks don't count. Use expressions to further limit the condition. For example, you could only count clicks on emails sent by a specific customer journey. This condition will now be true for leads that have clicked at least 3 times on links included in emails sent by the specific customer journey in the last 6 months. Finally, set the action tile to update the score by 15. If you only care about leads from a certain area, such as England, then add a second condition with an entity of a lead and an expressions that checks the country region field for a value of England. This rule will now give 15 points to leads from England that clicked on at least 3 email messages from a specific customer journey in the last 6 months. You can continue to build your model by adding more rules as condition action pairs. Each rule contributes to the score independently. Finally, you can set up a schedule of grades for categorizing lead scores with terms such as hot, warm, and cold, or A, B, and C. But the most important setting here is the sales ready score. When the lead reaches this score, it can trigger a workflow that advances to the sales acceptance stage, where a salesperson can review it and decide whether to move forward or recycle the lead. When you're done setting up your scoring model, choose Go Live to start using it to score your leads.